Hello everyone, in this video I will show you how to add an airfoil into Siemens NX sketch. I will be using Siemens NX 1980 series. For a start, we have to prepare our airfoil data file, which usually in format .dat. You can download it from the internet. We will use Excel to edit this file. For a CAD software, we will have to do some modifications. First, we have to delete the row name. Now we can see both X and Y coordinates are in one column. We have to separate them. Then we add the Z coordinates. So it needs all the three coordinates defined for each point. Now we have Z coordinate as with value of 0 for all points. As you can see, the first point and last one must have the same values because airfoils are closed curves, so this is will be the coincident point that will start and end at the same time. We can make a closed curve.
Some airfoils you might download.
You will find that first point isn't the same as last point. In this situation, you can search for another accurate one. Or you can modify this Excel sheet before you add it to NX, or we can use some NX features to modify it to make it a closed curve. Then we save the same file. It will be saved as .dat. Then we go to NX.
From NX, we will use a feature called spline.
But this one is planned to be retired because the new NX
spline has the ability
to import points from a file.
We will use the
through points. You can almost find spline using command finder. We will use through points. Select close curve. Then we select
or the file we prepared.
And okay. Then okay. Then cancel. We fit the screen. Now as you can see, we have imported the airfoil into our view. But this is not an NX sketch, it's called an untimestamp geometry. In other words, like a dummy geometry that you cannot modify or give it any parameters. You cannot attach it to another plane. You can extrude it, but it's not very functional or practical for our usage. We want it as a sketch, so we can do all the operations. So there are several options. Everyone has its own different usage depending on what you want. So we'll start in the first one. We collect open the sketch app and select similar plane to our which you can project our spline on. And okay, the first option is to choose include. We can include this curve into our sketch. It will be included as if it was like we can say a reference line. Not very practical, but we might need it some usage, and it maintains the same non-timestamp geometry. There are other options. When you go back, control that, we can choose project curve. Project curve projects the curve onto our sketch, and but it does maintain the same spline that we don't really need. There is another option, which is the best one. Is to add curve. From add curve, we can select the spline. It will make it into our sketch. It will delete the old non-timestamp geometry, and from this we can use it as like any normal sketch. We can choose reattach, for example. We can choose different plane for our curve. Can here from infer. Now we changed our plane for our sketch. Here's another way. A function similar to add curve, but not from the sketch app. It's from the curves app. It's called optimize 2D curve. It just takes the same curve. We select a similar plane. There is a value for distance threshold and angle threshold. It's not very important right now. You can check it later by yourself. And we click OK. Similar to add curve, it just optimizes the curve according to the values that you have added, and creates a sketch on this plane and deletes the non-time geometry. Ideally, we use the add curve. Oops, I've deleted line. We can do it again through points, close curve, points from file. Okay, and cancel sketch. Okay, then add curve. We can extrude it to make a fully wing. Okay, just fit. Now we have our wing. In some cases, we can have an Excel file or that file that's not closed curve. So in this situation, we will work on example with NASA 9. We'll open it using Excel. We'll delete the name column. We'll separate the data. Exit width. Next. Finish. Should have selected all column. Next column. Exit width. Finish. Then we add the Z coordinate. As you can see, the first point isn't the same as last point. We will just save it as it edited, then go for NX. NX will use the same feature, spline to be retired. And we select this time by bools, because it has better curve degree optimization. We select the first time curve degree one, then we'll modify it and see the difference. Select close curve and select NASA. No. And OK. Now select a point that started from it and give it like 0 and cancel. In this situation, we find that these two points are connected by NX in such manner. Then we will have to compare it with original one. Then we select, no, can't select it through points. We will not select it through closed curve, it's not actually closed. Then we select NASA. Okay, then cancel. We will click here on back. This is our first spline. Maybe I have this twice. Okay. This is the normal spline. This is the one made by bolts. You can see the difference here. We can double click on the curve or go here. Double click on the spline. And go for parameterization and change the degree. We can now create it into 2 and click OK. Now the is more like a curved this side instead of being just sharp angle. This is the original one, this is the modified one. If you modify the curves to another degree, it might deviate into unwanted shapes. Like if we created 3 or 10. We'll keep it just 2. You might think, why not we're using through points? Through points algorithm doesn't fit well with closing the curve. We can show you an example. We'll just select close curve, points from file, NASA. Cancel. Then we just hide the first one. Now this is one made by through points. Double click. We can modify the degree, create into 2. You can see now we are getting unusual shapes if you increase it. This is why we are using bibles in this situation. From here to the study spline, you can change it from bibles, grasp. But it's not the same as as the one you imported in the first time. So it's recommended that we delete this one and go for this one that we added a degree of 2. It's just the same as any other one we did before. We'll go, for example, like sketch, select the same plane, then add curves. Now it's added into sketch number 3, finish, and select sketch number 3 and extrude. Now we have another thing. This is how we do it, and thank you for watching.